Just a little more than a week away from Thanksgiving, and that means a visit to the grocery store.
Yes, but if you shop smart, you can save big time. The news station's Danielle Knox shows us.
Hi, guys. Well, guess what? I have my list, but I don't have to check it twice. Why? Rick Epley, the regional coordinator from Whole Foods, is here to show us what we need to do to get through that sometimes dreaded Thanksgiving meal without any stress at all. Hey, Rick.
Hey, nice to meet you. Thanks for coming.
I am so glad that you are going to be my savior today because I'm always stressed out. How much do I prepare? What do I buy? I don't want 3 weeks worth of leftovers. I'm sure this is something that you hear from customers all the time.
Every day. We hear it every day, and that's what we're here to help you with.
So are there some formulas or tactics that we can use so that we know how much to buy depending on how many people we want to feed?
Sure, absolutely. It's very easy. We can talk about vegetables, starches, herbs, the turkey, any kind of protein that you like for your meal, and we can break it down from there.
Let's do it.
All right.
So here we are at the potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
So my inclination would be to grab two or three bags,
okay,
not really knowing how much I need. What's the formula, or is there a formula for getting just the right amount?
Generally, I figure about 1 to 2 potatoes per person. If it's a little bit smaller potato like this, you're going to want to do about 2 per person. If it's a larger potato like that, you're going to do probably about 1 per person.
The other thing that, you know, everybody loves to make it in my family, I know we make it, is green bean casserole.
Mm-hmm.
How many green beans do we need?
You don't want to run out during the holiday, so I would say about 2 cups per person, because that's going to give you a little bit extra for everybody involved. So I want to grab a couple bags for 8 people, so maybe like about 4 or 5 bags for 8 people.
I love that. 4 or 5 bags.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's head on over to the stuffing area.
All right, come on this way.
For 8 people, how many bags would I need?
8 people, I would do 3 bags.
Okay.
Yep.
So let's talk about turkey. Let's
sure.
Talk turkey.
Talking turkey.
That's the other thing. It's like, you see these turkeys here. These guys mm-hmm. are huge. And sometimes you think, am I buying one that's too big? But I don't want to buy one that's too small. What is the rule of thumb here as it relates to turkey?
You want to maybe err on the side of caution. Do maybe like 1.5 to 1.75 pounds per person.
This turkey is 13 pounds.
So that might be right on the money.
The other thing, what about all the little things that we forget? The butter, the spices, the cranberry.
Right,
these
sure.
little things are things that we come running into the store, what, the day before because
exactly.
we forgot, right?
Exactly. You don't rely on your brain during this time of year because it's going to be occupied doing so many different things. Write a list without question.
You just said don't rely on my brain. You know what my brain just remembered?
What's that?
The why. Let's go. Just try it and see.
All right, great.
Like it. I think my
Zinfandel's a little peppery, a little spicy. It'll give your turkey dinner a little jazz.
There,
absolutely. Great
right
job.
One. I think that we are good. I love it. So there's so many options here, whether you want to cook, whether you don't want to cook, and you've given me such great advice in terms of proportion size, how much I need to feed my family of 8. I got to tell you, I love it. But here's the one thing that you forgot. Can you even think about maybe, what is it that I forgot? What do you think I'd really love?
Dessert.
Dessert.
We forgot dessert.
Dessert. We're going to go get dessert, okay? Bye, guys.